Good morning, Lakewood family. We are so happy that you are here with us. Whether you are joining us in person, online, or through Sirius XM radio, we're so honored that you made the decision to come home to Hope this morning. Let us know in the comments where you're watching from. Many of you join us from all over, and we want to personally welcome you. I see that we have Lily from New York joining us. Welcome, Lily. Selvi from India, Ronald from Chicago, Alice from Kenya. Thank you. God bless you. We are so honored that you're here with us this morning. Fadi from Lebanon. We have Elizabeth from Cincinnati, Maria from Canada, and Gregory from Dallas. Welcome. Thank you so much for being a part. We're going to have a great service today. You want to stay tuned. But just this last week, we had the Hope and Life Conference take place, where youth and young adults from all over the globe joined us here at Lakewood Church for an incredible time. I was here all 3 days, and I was so inspired to see our youth and young adults come together in their love for Jesus and find their passion and purpose in Christ. And every night was a powerful message and a time of worship, and we're very encouraged when we see that happening in our youth. But you know, the Hope and Life experience doesn't have to end. You can be a part each and every single week. Our youth meet every Wednesday, and our young adults meet every Thursday, and they meet on the fourth floor here at the church and have a wonderful time together. You can get notifications about next year's conference and anything going on in our youth and young adults. If you're in high school, just text youth to 77377. And if you're 18 and older, you can text LYA and you'll get more information. The information is on the screen now, but you don't want to miss a thing. Tomorrow, Monday, June 26th, Joel and Victoria will be back with another at-home inspiration break. And it happens at 5 p.m. Central Time, and it'll happen live on Facebook and YouTube. So you don't want to miss it. If you are not subscribed to our YouTube channel or following us on our social media, you should do that now so you don't miss an episode or another thing that comes out that you want to be a part of. If you've seen At Home Inspiration Break, Joel and Victoria do such a great job of answering your questions and sharing stories, and it's a really encouraging time. You don't want to miss it. As the summer continues to heat up, literally here in Houston, the temperatures are rising. You can stay cool in the building with your kids. If you have elementary kids aged through kindergarten through fifth grade, there is something going on every single Sunday with our summer fun days happening now and for the next 6 weeks. Every week there is a theme, a lesson, a craft for our kids to do. And my kids come each and every week, and I am so encouraged when I see them share about their the scriptures that they've learned and the message that they've heard. And it's just a really fun time. So if you're looking for things to do with your kids, please make time to come by on Sundays. You can get more information at lakewoodchurch.com. I know we're talking about summer, but back to school is coming sooner than we think. And, you know, while that's an exciting time for so many students, I know it can also be a difficult time for parents and teachers as they need supplies and resources to send their students back to school. And I'm happy to announce that our back to school drive is happening now through August 25th, and you can be a part of it. All you have to do is go to lakewoodchurch.com/give, and under the donation type drop-down menu, you can select back to school to be able to give something so that we can collect resources and supplies for students to go back to school. Now, what dream has God given you? You know, we're talking about the end of the school year, but the middle of the year and getting ready for the new school year, and here we are in the middle of the year. Is there a dream that you're holding on to? Well, our very own Nick Nilsson is coming out with a book on August 8th talking about the dreams that God has given you. It's entitled, You Can Live the Dream, but you don't have to wait until August 8th. You can pre-order now and be on the list to get the book when it comes out in August. But I know it's going to be a book that encourages you through the disappointments and trials that you face as you are on the journey to a dream come true. I know that book will be a valuable resource for you. Do you know that every 2 seconds someone is in need of blood? On Sunday, July 16th, the team from MD Anderson will be doing a blood drive here at the church. They're going to be here from 8:30 to 4:30. So if you're in the area, if you're here at service that day, please make plans to stop by so that you can donate blood. On our last blood drive, we had a total of 173 units donated, which meant that saved 519 lives. That's incredible. So if you're in the area, make sure that you stop by, sign up through lakewoodchurch.com/blood drive, and that's going to take place on Sunday, July 16th. Again, that's 4:30, that's 8:30 to 4:30. We've been talking about, you know, our dreams, and we've been talking about it being the middle of the year, and it's hard to believe that we're 6 months away from the end of the year, but I know we start the year with a lot of passion and excitement and goals and a hope for how we envision the year to go. And I think that's very important because how we start something determines how something could end as well. And this mid time of year is a great point for us to check in with the goals and the dreams that are put in our heart. Has some things happened in your life that made you feel like, you know what, that goal is not going to come to pass, or I am so far off track from where I thought I would be at this time? Or maybe you're just sitting in a very difficult place in your life right now, a lot of pain, a lot of sadness, and just wondering, God, where are you in the midst? Well, can I encourage you that God is right there with you, that He knows exactly where you are? I believe today's message from Joel is going to be such a powerful encouragement to you to help you keep dreaming and believing and knowing that nothing is impossible. I want to encourage you with the scripture from Ephesians 3:20. It says, now unto Him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. So God's power is working through our lives. Whether you might feel it or not, He is working behind the scenes of our life. He's working through you. And if you remind Him of those promises, if you remind Him of what He's said for your life, I believe that you're going to walk into the things that you have been dreaming about, waiting on God for. You know, there's another verse in Hebrews 10:23 that says, let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for He who promised is faithful. God is a faithful God. And He, I know you can, in so many areas of your life, recount ways that He has been a faithful God, where He has brought you through difficult seasons, where He has brought you through difficult times, where it seemed like it was over. God had another way to show you that the dream, the goal, His promise in your life was going to come to pass. And so I want to encourage you to tune in today, worship, open your heart to worship. Have your minds and your notepads ready to take notes today in today's message. You know, if there's something that you want to share with us, a testimony or a prayer request, go ahead in the chats and put that in the chats. Your testimony can encourage someone else. And a little bit later today, we're going to have prayer with Sarah Ridgway. And she'll pray over the needs that you send in. So if there's a prayer request or something that we can be praying with you about, please go in our chats and take a moment to write it down so that we can be believing in faith. You might wonder, you know, I don't want to do that. But you never know what your testimony and your message can do for someone else. And so take that step of faith. As I mentioned earlier, if you have not subscribed to any of our YouTube channels or following us on social media, please go and do that now so that you don't miss anything. We're so excited about today's service. It's going to be a wonderful time of worship, of the message. We're going to do a little recap of Hope and Life Conference, but this time that you spend is so valuable to your week, and it's so powerful in how the rest of your week goes. And so take a time to enjoy. As service is about to begin, we want to say God bless you.
God bless you and welcome to Lakewood. So awesome to have you on this beautiful summer morning. We welcome you, our online family, and listening live on SiriusXM. I know God has awesome things in store for you and your family. It's going to be a bountiful 2023.
Yes, it is. And I hope you just receive that. I hope you believe everything that you hear is not for someone else, but it's for you. So today, whatever you hear, just be a receiver and believe that God has your best interest at heart.
This is a new day. I'm calling out the mighty hero. The forces that are for you are greater than any force that's trying to stop you.
And we believe today, God, that you will do what only you can do.
He calls you a barrier breaker, a prized possession.
Welcome to Lakewood Church this morning. On behalf of our pastors, Joel and Victoria Osteen, we want to say welcome. We're so grateful that you chose to come and worship here this morning, whether you're in person, you're watching online, or listening by way of SiriusXM radio. Are there any guests here today? Any first timers here? Can you just put your hand up real high? Can we acknowledge all of our guests, all of our visitors here? We are so grateful. Whether you've come from Switzerland or you've come from different parts of Houston, wherever you're from, church, show some love to all of our guests one more time, all of our visitors. We are so grateful, those of you who tune in as well. This is the opportunity we get to release our faith. And I don't know if you've come in expecting or excited. You know, sometimes you can come in, it's been a long week, and getting the kids all ready, checking them into kids' life, getting into this. You can be tired, you can be worn out, and it kind of takes you a little bit to get going and kind of wake up. Well, here's the good news. Regardless of how you feel right now, God has been awaiting this moment. God is anxious to move in your life. The Bible says that he watches over his word, anxious to perform it. So I don't know if you're anxious or expectant or excited, but that's not my question. My statement to you today is, here's the truth. God is anxious to release his promise in your life today. He is watching over his word, anxious to perform it. And what moves God in your life is your faith. It's when you release your faith. And I know I'm surrounded by a bunch of believers today that are ready to release their faith, are ready to believe God, are ready to see miracles, are ready to receive all the things that he wants to give us. Victory is stored up for the righteous. Isn't that amazing? To think that there are things stored up for us that we could obtain and receive today in this atmosphere of faith. The last thing I want to encourage you with is this. Isaiah 58, it says, to let your voice be heard like a trumpet. Let your voice be heard like a trumpet. I know the person on your left and your right, they may have a good voice, but heaven wants to hear your voice today. Heaven wants to hear your voice get lifted. Just like your fingerprint is unique. It's unlike anyone else on the planet. Did you know your voice is unique? You can produce a unique sound to heaven today that no one else can create or produce. Isn't that cool? Now, I know you may be like me and you can't sing and it may not sound pretty, but it's significant in heaven today because it's an expression of your faith. So as you lift your worship, as you praise today, as you shout like we're about to do in a few seconds, heaven's gonna move. Heaven stands at attention because it's your voice. You're bringing a worship that no one else can bring today. So Father, right now in this atmosphere of faith, we just are gonna believe that you are gonna perform your word. You're watching over it, anxious to move. So as we release our faith and we give you our sound, we thank you that healing is on its way. Provision is on its way. Strength is on its way. Grace, joy, wisdom, all the things you have stored up for us is being unlocked in our direction. And we just stand in a posture to receive it today. We love you, we magnify you, and we lift up and shout your praises in Jesus' name. And everybody said, come on, lift your voice today and let's shout.
Impossible is what you do. church say, you will make a way. Come on, lift your voices. Oh, feel the atmosphere.
Yes, we are to see.
We believe that this morning, that there is none as powerful as you. There is no other name more powerful than your name. And so, Father, we focus on the size of you, Jesus, today. We don't focus on how big our problems are, how big our obstacles are, how big the giants are that are in front of us. We shift our perspective back to how big you are, how powerful you are. And we know that when we do that, you flood in our lives the peace that we need to get us through. You begin to fight battles for us. You begin to turn the tide of the battle in our favor. Father, we thank you that no weapon formed against us will prosper. Weapons may be forming all around us. We may be faced with an obstacle, received a bad report, but we can stand in confidence today knowing that all of those things shall not prosper. They cannot keep us from our destiny. They cannot keep us from reaching our full potential and possessing the dreams that you've set before us. Father, we thank you that you say in your word, the enemy may try to come in like a flood, but you raise up a mighty standard against him. I decree and declare a mighty heavenly standard around every person under the sound of my voice today. Father, thank you that you have gone before us, making crooked paths straight. You're leading us, you're guiding us, you're establishing our steps. Lord, your word says that the path of the righteous, it gets brighter and brighter. Oh, we can thank you today because our best days are not behind us. Our best days are still out in front of us. Our best opportunities, our best relationships, our best ideas, breakthroughs, miracles, they're still out in front of us, Jesus. We can stand in confidence today, knowing you're going to get us to where we need to be at the right time. You're opening up divine doors of opportunity and you're closing the wrong ones. You're bringing in the right people in our life and you're weeding out the wrong people. Lord, I just thank you that you're giving wisdom to those who need wisdom right now. Many people under the sound of my voice are making critical decisions in this season of their life, even this week. Lord, your word says that if we ask you for wisdom, that you'll give it to us generously. So thank you that you're giving us discernment. You're leading us, you're guiding us. You're establishing the steps of your people this week. God, I just thank you for supernatural counsel and direction. I don't know who needs to hear that today, but God is opening the right door for you. He's gonna take you where you need to be. He is going to bring the opportunities to you. You don't have to worry, you don't have to stress, you don't have to live in anxiety. God is gonna bring you what has your name on it. Victory is stored up for the righteous. Thank you that as we look to you, Jesus, you are unlocking everything that has our name on it. We don't have to push, we don't have to strive or strain, but you will get us what we need at the right time. You will put our name where it needs to be. You'll put our resume where it needs to be. God, I thank you that you have stored up riches, Lord, resources for us. Lord, we're not limited to our contact book. We're not limited to our place of employment, but you will meet all of our needs according to your riches and glory. Oh, I thank you today that you are going to pour down heavenly resources to those who need it right now in Jesus' name. Not just meeting our needs, but putting us in a position of overflow so we can be a bigger blessing to those who are around us. Thank you that you're transforming us. You're making us, you're molding us into who we need to be. That you are the one who started the work in us, and your word says you are faithful to finish it. So thank you that we are getting better. We are getting stronger. Father, I thank you that you are healing every sick body under the sound of my voice. I speak to every cell, bone, ligament, tissue, muscle, that everything in our body is operating exactly how you've designed it to operate in the name of Jesus. By your stripes, we were healed. We take hold of that healing right now in Jesus' name. God, I thank you that you're comforting those who are working through loss, experiencing loss, that are grieving today. Lord, I thank you that you are with us. Even in the valley of the shadow of death, you are there. You are with us. You are comforting those who need comfort, your peace, and your presence. You are a strong rock, a foundation for those who need it right now. You can be trusted that you will take us through every hardship. You will guide us through every storm. That valley isn't our final destination, but you will continue to lead us forward to the places you have destined and planned for us to experience. Morning may last for a night, but oh, joy comes in the morning. Lord, we thank you for great joy for those who need to experience it. Lord, I thank you that our best days, again, are not behind us, but they're still out in front of us. I decree and declare that 2023 is not just an average get-by year, but we're gonna see your goodness, we are gonna see your favor, we are gonna experience miracles and breakthroughs like never before. If you believe and receive that, church, oh, I wish you'd lift your voice. Come on, can you thank God and praise him for what we're gonna experience? Oh, he's a good God, isn't he? We can anchor to him through any season. We can look to him to provide. We can look to him for peace. But before we go any further, I just want to lead us in a declaration like we do every Sunday. I don't know what people have labeled you. I don't know what they've put on you. I don't know what they've told you. But this is the time of the service every week where we get reminded. We get reminded to who God says we are. This is who God says you are. Can you repeat it with faith and with conviction? Come on, say it like you mean it. I am blessed, prosperous, redeemed, forgiven, healthy, whole, talented, creative, confident, secure, disciplined, focused, prepared, qualified, motivated, valuable, free, determined, equipped, empowered, anointed, accepted, and approved. Not average, not mediocre. I am a child of the Most High God. I will become all I was created to be in Jesus' name. Amen. You sound great this morning. You sound great. Hey, we're gonna take a moment to pray, but before we do so, I wanna encourage you. I know many people are working through storms and challenges, and the biggest thing many people need right now is peace. Peace to sustain us, peace to guide us through. And the Bible says that we can have a peace that the world can't offer, that we can experience this, that Jesus gives us this opportunity to experience peace that surpasses understanding. This is a peace that the world can't give, and it's a peace the world can't take away. Aren't you grateful for that? Aren't you grateful for a powerful peace that Jesus can offer us today? A storm can be all around you, but that storm doesn't have to be in you. And that's what makes the believer powerful, is that you can walk through things that are very challenging and very difficult, and they're real. You see them, you feel them, you hear them, but it doesn't have to get on the inside of you. You can still walk in peace, and you can walk in authority, and you can walk in power, and you can walk in joy. Not because everything is good around you, but because the God of the universe is activating peace on the inside of you. And so today, what I'm saying is that peace is available for you. And all it requires is for you to cast your care onto Jesus today. If you are struggling with anything, if you're walking through a storm, exchange the anxiety and the challenges and the frustration and the sadness and the worry for peace today. When you pray, God says he gives us peace in exchange. So cast your cares, and what are you gonna catch today? You're gonna catch peace. You're not gonna leave this place empty. You're gonna leave this place full of peace today. Whether you're here or you're watching or you're listening by way of radio, let's experience his peace. Our prayer partners are gonna come, and they're gonna stand in front of every section. And if you have any worry, anything weighing you down, let's exchange that for peace today. Can we do that? So let's go ahead and let's take a moment to pray. You can come and find a prayer partner and join your faith with them. And they're gonna believe for miracles today on your behalf. The rest of us, let's continue to pray or continue to worship as we pray. God bless you today.
Good morning, Lakewood family. We are so thrilled that you've decided to join us online today, and we believe that God has blessings in store for you, and we want to stand in agreement for those blessings coming your way. So as the people in the building and the prayer partners are praying for one another, it is my honor to be here with you today and stand in agreement with you over the things that you're asking God for. You know, the Bible says that draw near to God and He will draw near to you. And that's what praying does. It's fixing our eyes on God and not necessarily the situations or the prayers or the struggles that are going on, but it's fixing in on Him and drawing close to Him and allowing Him to guide us and lead us and teach us in the way we should go in these areas. So if you have a prayer request you would like for us to be in agreement with you this morning, throw it in the live chats during this live stream. Otherwise, you can contact us 24/7 on joelosteen.com/community, and we'd be happy to pray with you any time of the week. But again, I remember reading in Psalms, and David said that the moment I called, that you came and my enemies fled. So let's begin to call on God now for the things that that we need Him for. Many of us have broken hearts or maybe financial issues or a sudden loss of something. There's so many things, but I promise you that nothing is unknown to God. Nothing that you are going through has slipped through His fingers and gone unnoticed, that He cares. And what we're doing is bringing those to Him, getting them off our chest, so to speak, and allowing God to do what only He can do, just like we were singing earlier. So I always like to start with some praise reports, and I see those have been coming in because here at Lakewood, I love it how we hear our pastors say all the time, like, let's focus on the things that are going right. You know, so many things can go wrong or people doing wrong in our lives, but when we take a moment to praise God and to thank God for the things going right, it literally shifts the atmosphere and changes our perspective in a whole new direction. So real quick praise reports. Maria, it says here that her health has been improving quicker than the doctors predicted. Amen. That's amazing. I always say sometimes the doctors, we're so thankful for doctors and the way God gives them intelligence. And sometimes the doctors do their best to give us some sort of a report. But I like to say, I always like to look to God and say, God, what does your report say? Because that's the one I'm going to follow. So we just are so glad with you, Maria, that it's improving and that you are just mystifying the doctors. So that's amazing. Laura, it said, has recovered her mobility in her hips and legs. So you've recovered mobility, obviously, that once was lost. You know, I've seen it happen. I've seen it happen, and we'll see Him do it again. So today, if that's an area you're struggling with, right here is the proof that if God will do it for one and give her mobility back in her hips and legs, He'll do it for you as well. So we just believe that right now. In the area of careers, I have Kevin, you're believing for a breakthrough in your career. It's important what we're doing, what our work is on this earth. Amy, to be able to pass her certification exams. Amy, I'm in agreement with you. We just pray. You know, I always think when we're studying for things, we do our part in the natural. We study, we show our work approved, we do what we're supposed to do on our jobs. And then as we do what we can do in the natural, God puts His super on our natural, and supernatural things begin to occur. So I believe with you, Amy, that's what's going to happen. Everything you've put your mind to is going to be brought back during that certification. Rev, you said that to become an HISD teacher. Amen. I went to school to be a teacher. I used to teach high school. We need good ones out there. So we just agree with you that if that's the desire of your heart, that HISD needs you and needs your heart. So we just pray right now that God opens the doors that need to be opened and close the one that needs to be closed in Jesus' name. All right. Several of you have chimed in about finances. We know what the economy says. We know inflation is growing. But again, whose report are we going to believe? I choose to believe in God's report. And He says that He's a provider with more than enough. And I don't think, sometimes people say, oh, you're just praying for, you know, for money. Well, God knows it's important to us. That's how we function in this society. It's not all of what prosperity means. Prosperity is in our health, in our relationships, in our joy, in our mental health. But finances are important, so we don't want to leave those out. Nancy, you need a new car. We're agreeing with you that those finances will be made available to you and you will get what you need. It's important. Ariel, for financial breakthrough, we disagree. Breakthrough is yours and coming. We just sang about it. If you were listening in the service, if not, rewind. and go listen to some of the songs that we're playing, because worship will always encourage you. James, for financial freedom, amen. I grab hold of that as well. To be out from under anything that's causing us to feel bound or struggled or stressed, we want financial freedom. And God is more than able. Again, as we do our part and become good stewards with what He's given us, God will put His super on our natural and cause those supernatural freedom that we are longing for. For healing, so many of us are having ailments in our bodies or in our minds, but Barbara, you're praying to be healed from cancer. And so we just speak right now to those cancerous disease, just be healed in Jesus' name, that every cell in her body lines up and functions according to the way God designed it to. Ben, for your mother who recently got paralyzed, we were just giving the praise report of the woman that got her mobility in her legs and hips back. So we just agree again that if God will do it for one, He'll do it for you as well. So Ben, we agree together that your mother will get her mobility back after being deemed paralyzed. And Sarah, you wrote that you would like to be healed from stomach issues. I don't know the details, and probably with so many of you that put your comments in the chats, I don't know the details of what's going on, but God does. And He's near to you. He's near to the brokenhearted. He cares about our diseases, and He wants what's best for us. So again, we just right now lift the name of God up in your lives. Know that we pray for you every day, and don't walk this out alone. Get involved in a community and find someone. We'll be back later, but God bless you.
A dead thing, it still has to hear Him. Even things that died have to respond to His voice. And if things that are dead have to respond, how much more for us who are still alive?
Talking to a generation of believers that will rise up and call things out, start seeing with eyes of faith, not just for themselves, but for others. A crazy faith type of group. Just have enough faith to say, yeah, yeah, I know what you see. It's dry, it's dead, but let me tell you what God sees.
David doesn't become king without Goliath. David does not become king. David is not promoted without a giant, but the giant is always there to reveal the greatness of your God and the greatness that's on the inside of you and the weakness of your enemy. The giant you are facing is revealing that you are bigger on the inside than Goliath is on the outside.
Well, we just hosted our annual youth and young adult conference called Hope and Life, and it was amazing. It was powerful. And, you know, the theme this year, it was come to life. And we believe that thousands came to life because they encountered the one who gives life, Jesus. You know, that theme, that phrase, come to life, it's not just for young people. We believe it's for all people. And so my question for us today, Lakewood family in the room and those of you who are watching online, is what are you believing God for to come alive in your life? Perhaps it's a family member that you've been believing for, or maybe it's financial struggle, or maybe you're in the middle of making a difficult decision. You know, as I was preparing for my message, I began to ask the question, what does it mean to come to life? Does something need to die in order for it to be resurrected? It's a difficult concept to break down. Okay, so true story, can't even make this up. On Tuesday of this past week, literally one day before conference begins, I wake up in the morning, I spend some time in prayer, go to my kitchen table, open up my computer to review my message, and then an alert pops up and it says, error, forcing a shutdown. Now, I didn't really think much of it because I back up all my documents. I thought, okay, it does an auto save, we should be good here. And so it does a restart, a refresh, and to my surprise, when I open it up, my message is completely gone, lost forever. Has that ever happened to you? You lose a document, you're wondering, it's vanished, where did it go? And inside you are saying,
No!
Slow-mo. Why? And outside, you're just cool, calm, and collected. This is fine. This is great. We can come up with a solution. And I asked God, I said, okay, God, do you really, you want me to write a whole message in one day? We could do this. Okay. I'll do whatever you want me to do, God. I trust you. I say a prayer, and as one last attempt, I go back to look for that document. Well, I did find the latest version. But right there, in little bitty font, it reads, do you want to restore to this version? And I clicked the option that said, yeah. And in that moment, I said, oh, wow, God, you are awesome. You just did that, didn't you? You were speaking to me all along. I went and grabbed my notebook and I wrote it down on a piece of paper. I probably even have a picture of it here. And I said, come to life means to restore what is already written. Isn't God good like that? You know, there are words that have already been written. And for us as believers, we got to take a hold of these words. Words like, I will see the goodness of God in the land of the living. I'm going to see my family member come to know you. Words like, I'm more than a conqueror. I can get past this financial situation. Words like, I'm the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. And I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And we take hold of these things. I believe that we can be restored to not just the master version, but get this, the master's version. And when we do that, I believe that we will come to life.
Only God can cultivate barren ground and bring forth life. He looks at the dead places and sees potential. He looks at dust and sees ingredients to make mankind. Are you in a valley of dry bones? Have you lost hope? Has it been a long time since you've seen life and vibrance around you? Dreams, visions, passion, love, relationships don't have to be finished. Even if the bones are dry. In other words, even if things have seemed dead for a while, God can still look at those things and say, come to life. Throw your shoulders back. Hold your head up. Lift your hands. Bow your heart. Breathe in the breath of life. This is a message for the church, for the here and the now. God is still saying, come to life.
He walked up to the tomb and he told them to roll the stone away. And Lazarus, he shouted his name. He said, Lazarus, come forth. And Lazarus did. He came back to life. And just like that, he had vibrance in his body. He had vitality. He had health. He had strength. So my question today is, what tomb do you need Jesus to stand in front of? What place do you need him to stand in front of and call out the thing that's dead in your life? Because he's willing and he's able, and he's still able and going to do it for you. I don't know about you, but it feels like now's a good time for a miracle. I don't know who needs to hear this, but he's still in the business of breakthrough. He's still in the business of recycling. He's still in the business of restoration. He's still in the business of doing the impossible. God is still in the business of making dead things come back to life. So I decree and declare that your marriage that's struggling is coming back to life. That your finances that are struggling, they're coming back to life. That your mental health that's been faltering, that's been fickle, is starting to come back to life. So Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for every person in this room and watching online. God, I thank you, God, that you are doing a unique thing in this season for them to come back to life. God, we decree and declare that you are good and that your mercy endures forever, and we will experience the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. If you believe it, in Jesus' name, everybody said, amen.
Stay in faith. God knows how to bring dead things back to life. So great to have you at Lakewood today. We'll take a moment to receive our tithes and our offerings. And always want to thank you for your generosity and supporting the ministry with your tithes and your donations. You are impacting people all over the world. I love what the scripture says, that no good thing will God withhold because you walk uprightly. I believe because you keep God first place, you honor him in your time, your resources, in what you do, I believe there's no good thing God's going to withhold from you. That means he's not going to withhold the health, not going to withhold the wisdom, the right people, or the finances so you can become who you were created to be. Why don't you live with that mentality? God, I thank you that I live under the open windows of heaven. God, that you're smiling down on me, that there's no good thing that you withhold. I think sometimes we think, I don't deserve it, and I didn't do good enough here, and I don't come from the right family. No, get rid of that. God is pleased with you. He sees your generosity. He sees your obedience. He sees you in church today. He sees you online and listening. No good thing is he going to withhold. Let me tell you, good breaks are coming. The right people are coming. Abundance is coming. It's going to be a bountiful 2023 for you and your family.
Hi, I'm Debbie Sonier with Anchor Point's Hope House Maternity Home. And we just want to say a big thank you to Lakewood Church and all that y'all have done to help support us. We now have 5 residents and 1 baby. So we are growing and thriving and couldn't be more thankful for everything that Lakewood did to make this possible. We can house up to 6 residents. Our girls are ages 16 and up. They are able to stay here for up to 18 months, during which time they are enrolled in an accredited education program. Also, we provide life skills trainings here at the house. Bible studies, spiritual mentoring. So it's just a full service of giving these girls a really great chance to thrive and to transition into independent living. We again are so thankful for y'all's support and the partnership that you have provided to Hope House. Thank you.
We are truly better together. See, it's in times like these, all of us doing our part, making lives better for those in need. Joel and I want to thank you for your obedience to honor God with your finances. Because of your efforts, the heartbeat of God is being demonstrated and lives are being impacted in wonderful ways.
We do appreciate you. Let me speak a blessing. Lord, thank you for all of our generous givers. Lord, I thank you what you promised, that no good thing will you withhold. Lord, I thank you that you'll show out in their lives in a new way, blessing them so they could be a bigger blessing. Lord, do what only you can do. Open up new doors of opportunity. Thank you that you're bringing business and contracts and ideas and creativity and divine connections. Lord, I thank you that you're blessing them in ways just so they can be a bigger blessing, so they can bring about your kingdom. And Lord, that so we can just see lives touched all over the world. I speak your abundance and supernatural provision. Lord, help those that are struggling in their finances. I thank you that you would show out in their lives and just show them a sign of your favor in Jesus' name. God bless you today as you give.
Here are some ways you can give. Scan the QR code using your smartphone. Text Give Hope to 77977. Go online to lakewoodchurch.com/give or call us toll free at 888-567-JOEL. Your giving is changing lives all over the world.
I'm the good news to the bound and the poor.
Comfort. I hope you receive that into your spirit. He is the great I am. He is your peace. He is your joy. He is our provider. He is our way maker. He's done it in the past. He's going to do it again. Thanks for being at Lakewood today. We love you guys. Thanks to our beautiful choir and for our whole worship team. But we're honored to have you in the house of the Lord. I'm going to do something different today. I'm away, but I've prepared a message for you. I believe it's God's word for today, and you let it take root in the good soil of your heart. It's alive and full of power, and I'm excited about sharing this with you today. And if you're visiting, honored to have you at Lakewood. Come back whenever you can. And we did have a beautiful Hope and Life conference with thousands of young people, and we just celebrate what God is doing. We're going to have a blessed summer here at Lakewood, and we're just honored to have you all in the house of the Lord, in person, online, listening live by SiriusXM. But come on, are you ready? Are you standing? I hope you're all standing with me. Let's say it together. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I will be taught the Word of God. I boldly confess, my mind is alert, my heart is receptive, I will never be the same. I am about to receive the incorruptible, indestructible, ever-living seed of the Word of God. I'll never be the same, never, 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 I'll never be the same, in Jesus' name. God bless you. Don't forget, we have an awesome Spanish service today at 2:00, and then we have our young adult services on Wednesday night, on Thursday night, our college age students, but always something good for you in the house of the Lord. And again, blessed to have you at Lakewood. I want to talk to you today about in the middle of a miracle. When we go through challenges, it's easy to live worried and stressed, and we wonder when it's going to change and when God is going to do something, when in fact, God is doing something. He's keeping the sickness from taking us out. He's holding back the opposition. He's not letting the addiction defeat us. We don't realize it, but we're in the middle of a miracle. God is in the process of bringing us out. Without His favor, we would be overcome. Without His protection, we would be defeated. One day we'll look back and say, look what the Lord has done. Look at how God sustained me in that tough time. Look at how He healed me from that disease. Look at how He promoted me despite the opposition. Right now, God is working behind the scenes, making things happen that you can't see. If it wasn't for His goodness, His favor, His mercy, you wouldn't be able to withstand what's trying to stop you. You're not in the difficulty by yourself. The Most High God is pushing back forces of darkness. One time, Joshua and his men were in a valley fighting the Amalekites. They had attacked the Israelites, and they were bigger and stronger. But against all odds, Joshua was winning. The whole time, Moses was up on the hill holding his staff in the air. As long as he had his staff up, Joshua was winning. I could imagine Joshua thought he was defeating the opposition in his own strength. He didn't realize the only reason he was prevailing was because Moses was holding up his staff. Sometimes we think we're making it through the difficulty because we're tough, we're determined, we're smart, and that's part of it. But what you can't see is the Creator of the universe is breathing in your direction. The God who spoke worlds into existence is sustaining you, favoring you, healing you. Like Moses up on that hill, you can't see him, but God is causing you to win. That's why that car barely missed you on the freeway. That's why that addiction couldn't finish you off. That's why that person that did you wrong couldn't stop your destiny. The forces that are for you are greater than forces that are against you. Paul said that God always causes us to triumph. If you're not seeing victory yet, don't panic. You're in the middle. That's not how your story ends. God is holding up the staff, so to speak. You can't be defeated. The enemy can't stop God's plan for your life. Healing is coming. Freedom is coming. Breakthroughs are coming. God is about to show out in your life. He's going to do things you can't do on your own. It's going to be uncommon. That's why you can't figure it out. It's not going to be natural. It's going to be supernatural. But in the middle, it can be frightening. In the middle, all you see is the opposition, how big the obstacle looks, how bad the problem is. Thoughts will tell you it's never going to work out. You'll never get well, never break the addiction, never meet the right person. But you have to remind yourself that things are happening that you can't see. It may look permanent. You don't see anything improving. The truth is, it's only the middle. Your time is coming. God wouldn't have allowed it if it was going to keep you from your destiny. Now keep the right perspective. You're not just fighting cancer. You're in the middle of a miracle. God is in the process of restoring your health. That test one day will be your testimony. You will say with David, "Where would I be without the goodness of God?" You're not just struggling in your finances. You're in the middle of a miracle. The enemy thought he was setting you back. He didn't realize he was setting you up. Your story doesn't end in defeat. God is about to do a new thing. Promotion is coming. Opportunities are coming. The right people. "Well, Joel, but the stock market is down. I don't have the work I used to." The economy is not your source. God is your source. The stock market may be down, but God is not having a bad year. He owns it all. One touch of His favor will put you into overflow. When you keep God first place, when you honor Him with your life, you are connected to a supply line that will never run dry. The scripture says, even in famine, you will have more than enough. When things are drying up all around you, you should be in lack, struggling, barely making it. You will see supernatural provision, increase, promotion, opportunity that doesn't make sense. Isaiah said that God makes rivers in the desert. He makes streams in the barren places. You can't have a river in a desert. If it's barren, you can't have water freely flowing. This is showing us God is going to do unusual things. He's going to take you up when all the circumstances say you should be going down. He's going to bring opportunity and promotion when things should be drying up. You're not only going to be amazed, but people are going to see the favor of God is on your life. "Well, Joel, this sounds good, but I don't know. It's tough in my life. Things are slow at work. I lost a contract. I don't see how I'm going to make it." That's calling in more defeat. Turn it around. "Yes, things are slow, but I know a secret. I'm in the middle of a miracle. God is working behind the scenes. He's supplying all of my needs. He has a hedge of protection around my family." Get in agreement with God. You can't talk defeat and have victory. You can't think negative and live positive. You can't go around worried, afraid, panicked, and reach your destiny. You're drawing in what you're thinking about. Don't use your energy to worry. Use your energy to believe. After God delivered the Israelites out of slavery, they headed toward the promised land. But Pharaoh changed his mind and sent 600 of his fastest chariots and most skilled warriors to recapture them. And these 2 million Israelites were at a dead end at the Red Sea. They had nowhere to go. Moses held up his staff and the waters parted. And it's interesting how God brought them out. We read about it now, and it's so encouraging and inspiring. These huge walls of water being held back, the people walking through on dry ground. In the movies, they're going through so peaceful and calm, and rejoicing at what God had done. But I don't think that's how it happened. Imagine being there with 20 feet walls of water on each side, not knowing if at any moment those walls were going to collapse. Mothers were holding their babies for dear life, rushing through. Fathers grabbing their little children's hands, running as fast as they could. People carrying the elderly. It wasn't peaceful. It was chaotic. The wind was holding back the water. It was incredibly noisy. There was confusion, turmoil. People were panicked, worried, thinking any moment those walls could come crashing down. They weren't calm and collected. They were afraid. They finally made it to the other side and they started rejoicing. They started giving God praise. When you're in the middle of the miracle, sometimes it will feel chaotic. You may not hear angels playing harps and the heavenly choir singing. The circumstances may not be calm and reassuring. It may look like all hell is breaking loose. The medical report looks worse. Your child won't do what's right. Inflation is rising. It's easy to panic, live worried, not able to sleep at night. God is saying, be still and know that I am God. Those walls of water may look scary. You could think of 100 things that could go wrong, but God didn't bring you this far to leave you. He's the one holding up the walls. He's the one pushing back the forces of darkness. He's the one keeping the trouble from defeating you. It may look frightening. The circumstances seem overwhelming. Stay in peace. You're in the middle of a miracle. God may not deliver you from the trouble. He may take you through the trouble. Those walls of water that look so intimidating, that's not a sign that you're done. That's a sign that breakthroughs are up ahead. Promotion, freedom, healing is in your future. Yes, the winds are strong. The opposition is bigger than anything you face, but it's not a surprise to God. He's not going to let the water collapse. He's going to bring you through safely to the other side. It's interesting how God brought the Israelites out. He didn't give them a bridge to cross the Red Sea. That would have been much more peaceful. They wouldn't have had to worry about those walls of water. He could have sent them a big ship, had Carnival Cruise pull up with several of their cruise liners. The Israelites could have gone across in comfort, secure, not had any fears. But God doesn't always bring us out the most comfortable way. He doesn't always make it easy to where we don't have any opposition, any reason to live worried or afraid. This is what faith is all about. Trusting Him in between the walls of water. Being at peace when others are panicked. Staying calm when you don't know how it's going to work out. The scripture says that God sent a strong east wind to blow the waters back. Imagine how strong that wind had to be to blow back 20 feet of water and sustain it. That means it had to keep blowing. It was loud, noisy, chaotic. In one sense, God sent a storm on top of another storm. You could think, this couldn't be God. Things are getting worse instead of better. But you don't know what God is up to. Those winds that are so noisy, the trouble, the opposition, that's not going to keep you from your destiny. It's leading you to your destiny. You're not close to your miracle only when everything is calm and peaceful. Sometimes it's the opposite. When it's chaotic, when you're tempted to panic, live afraid and worried, that means your miracle is on the way. There's a lot going on in the world today, and with all the uncertainty, we could live worried. Man, what about my finances? And this sickness is not improving, and I'm concerned about my children. Come back to a place of peace. We may not know what the future holds, but we do know who holds the future. God is still on the throne. You can't see it, but He's holding up the walls of water. He's keeping you from evil and harm. He's sustaining you in the famine. He's bringing healing and wholeness. He's protecting, providing, favoring. You're in the middle of a miracle. Now do like Paul and Silas. They were arrested for sharing their faith and put in the deepest dungeon, locked behind prison doors with chains on their feet. They could have been depressed, complaining, but they understood this principle, that they were not just in the middle of a dungeon, they were in the middle of a miracle. They knew the same God that sent the wind to blow back the Red Sea for the Israelites could make a way where they didn't see a way. And at midnight, they started singing praises to God. When you can sing in a storm, when you can praise through the pain, when you can thank God that He's working instead of complaining about the trouble, get ready, your miracle is on the way. All of a sudden, there was a great earthquake. Prison doors flung open, the chains fell off their feet. They walked out as free men. God sent an earthquake. He used another storm to get them out of a storm. Don't be surprised if God does it an unusual way. Like Paul and Silas, you may feel like you're in the middle of trouble, dealing with an illness, worried about your finances, concerned about your children. What you're up against seems bigger and stronger. You have to do like them and recognize you're not just in the middle of a difficulty, you're in the middle of a miracle. If you will start thanking God that He's working, thanking Him that He's bigger than what you're facing, thanking Him that He's holding up the walls of water, then you're going to see situations suddenly turn around. Suddenly you get well. Suddenly your child gets back on course. Suddenly the problem resolves. When you're in the middle of a miracle, you have to turn up your praise. Father, thank You that no weapon formed against me is going to prosper. Thank You that this difficulty didn't come to stay, that it came to pass. Thank You that even now things are changing in my favor. I know a young man named Chris. He's been attending Lakewood with his family since he was 9 years old. And he grew up healthy and very active. But at 17, he started having fever and fluctuation in his weight. He eventually lost the strength and mobility in his legs. After 2 weeks in the hospital, he was diagnosed with a rare form of lupus. He could have been discouraged, given up on life, but Chris is a fighter. He knew he wasn't just in the middle of a rare sickness, he was in the middle of a miracle. He decorated the walls of his house with scripture verses. I will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. By His stripes I am healed. Chris started volunteering here at Lakewood. I would see him faithfully serving and helping others year after year. I've never heard Chris complain, never seen him without a smile. If you ask him how he's doing, he's going to tell you that he's blessed, that he's healed, that he has the favor of God. It's one thing to believe when everything is going your way. That's easy. The real test comes when life has thrown you a curve, when you're facing something that's out of your control. Chris continued to struggle with his health. One day he looked like he'd gained 50 pounds, and another day he looked like skin and bones. He spent time in and out of the hospital, fighting the good fight of faith. Didn't seem like he was in the middle of a miracle. The medical report said he would never get well. But God can do what medicine cannot do. Medical science may run out of options, but God never runs out of options. He breathed life into you. He has the final say. Nothing can snatch you out of His hands. When Chris was 40 years old, after fighting for over 20 years, his heart and kidneys began to fail. He was hospitalized and given a temporary pump to keep his heart beating. The doctor said his only chance of survival was a heart transplant. He was placed on the waiting list, but there were so many ahead of him, it seemed unlikely that he would make it. He'd been in the hospital for 5 months in ICU. Doctors told him that all of his organs would start shutting down. Chris wouldn't hear of it. He kept declaring health, wholeness, victory, and much to their surprise, he defied the odds and his other organs remained healthy. One night, his wife unexpectedly received the call that they'd been praying for so long. There was a donor for Chris. It just so happened it was a perfect match. Not only a heart like they were praying for, but there were two kidneys as well. The family stood outside, took pictures of that ambulance arriving with Chris's new organs. He had the heart and the kidney transplant at the same time. The surgery was successful, and Chris is well on his way to the life he's been dreaming about, healthy and whole. There was a prayer that he prayed every day from Psalm 51. God created me a clean heart. He said, God not only gave me a new heart, but He gave me kidneys as well. That's the way our God is. He exceeds our expectations. It may look like that sickness is permanent, that addiction is never going to change, you'll never see your family restored, it's too late, the problem too big. Can I encourage you? You're in the middle of a miracle. God already has the solution. It's already lined up the good breaks, the healing, the right people. Don't believe the lies that you've seen your best days. Do like Chris and live from a place of faith, a place of trust. You look at the circumstances, you could be worried, negative, thinking it's never going to change. But if Chris were here, he would tell you, God is a faithful God. Your time is coming. He's not only going to do what you ask, he's going to exceed your expectations. The scripture says, is there anything too hard for God? He spoke worlds into existence. He flung stars into space. He has you in the palm of his hand. What he's destined for your life will come to pass. And I believe right now, faith is rising in your heart. Dreams are coming back to life. Promises you've given up on are about to be fulfilled. You may be in a difficult time, but have a new perspective. You're in the middle of a miracle. The enemy wouldn't be coming against you if he didn't know something amazing was in front of you. This is not the time to live worried and afraid. The God who breathed life into you is watching over you. He's keeping the walls up. He's pushing back the opposition. He's ordering your steps, putting you at the right place at the right time. Isaiah said, say to the righteous, it shall be well with you. You are the righteous. You wouldn't be listening if you didn't have a heart after God. There's a lot of fear and panic in the world, but that is not going to stop your destiny. It shall be well with you. The medical report may not look good. You've been dealing with that sickness for years. It's not permanent. It shall be well with you. Healing is on the way. You lost a loved one. You don't think you could go on. It's not the end. God has a new beginning. Let this phrase sink down in your spirit. It shall be well with you. Or you had a setback in your finances. Business slowed. You don't know how you're going to make it. God has it all figured out. He's your provider. He clothes the lilies of the fields. He feeds the birds of the air. He knows how to take care of you. New doors are going to open. Opportunities are going to come looking for you. It shall be well with you. Now, the circumstances may look the opposite. Things are coming against you in your health, your finances, your relationships. It may not be well now, but you have the promise it shall be well. The opposition, the trouble, the lack, it's not the end. Why? You're in the middle of a miracle. Victory is coming. Healing is coming. Freedom is coming. New levels are coming. 2 Kings chapter 7, the Syrian army had surrounded the city of Samaria and cut off their food supply. The Israelites were starving and faced certain death. There were four lepers sitting outside the city gates. They said, we're going to die here anyway. Let's go down to the enemy's camp and see what they're doing. They started walking toward the Syrians. God caused the sound of their footsteps to be multiplied. The scripture says the Syrian army heard the clatter of thousands of speeding chariots and the sound of a vast army approaching. They were so afraid, they panicked. They took off running into the desert, fleeing for their lives. They left in such a hurry, they didn't take any of their possessions, any of their food, their supplies, their gold, their silver. They left everything behind. When the lepers arrived, they couldn't believe it. They didn't know what happened. They went back and told the Israelites. They came and gathered up all their food and belongings. It was a great victory. What's interesting is when the lepers were walking to the enemy's camp, they didn't hear anything different. Even though God multiplied the sound of their footsteps, they couldn't hear it. Everything seemed normal to them. They were just doing what they knew to do. What they couldn't see was God was working behind the scenes, doing things they never dreamed. In the natural, they didn't have a chance, but we serve a supernatural God. They thought it was the end, that there was no way they could live. All the odds were against them. They didn't realize they were in the middle of a miracle. God was making things happen that they knew nothing about. When you're doing the right thing, making decisions that honor God, you may not see anything improving. You still have that problem at work. Your health hasn't gotten better. Your finances look just the same. What you can't see is God is behind the scenes orchestrating things in your favor, lining up the breaks you need, moving the wrong people out of the way. Seems like where you are is permanent, but God is causing people to hear what they need to hear. He's multiplying what you know nothing about. You're going to see things fall into place that don't make sense. Like these lepers, you'll be scratching your head thinking, how did that happen? You thought you were stuck in your career, gone as far as you could, but out of nowhere, promotion came to you. A door opened that you could never open. You thought you would never get well, but it wasn't the end. Like Chris, you were in the middle of a miracle. Against all odds, your health began to turn around. Now, what if these lepers would have thought, man, we don't have a chance. No use walking down there. That's just wasting our time. They would have missed their miracle. Every circumstance said they were done. They were outnumbered. They had a dreaded disease. But when they dared to take that step of faith, things supernaturally turned around. You may have opposition, things coming against you. You don't see how that situation could ever resolve. But if you'll just keep moving forward in faith, knowing that God is in the process of bringing you out, that He's making things happen that you can't see, not believing those lies that where you are is permanent, then you're going to come into these times where God shows out in your life, where He makes things happen that you could never make happen. Don't let the fact that it's stressful, you're tempted to be panicked and worried, convince you that it's not going to work out. Most of the time, when you're in the middle of a miracle, it's not peaceful. There are walls of water on each side that could collapse. There's a Pharaoh chasing you. There's wind and noise. Don't panic. God has you right where He wants you. He's in control. He's keeping the opposition from defeating you. It's just a matter of time before you make it safely to the other side. I'm asking you to live from a place of peace, a place of trust. If you'll do this, I believe and declare forces that are trying to stop you are being broken right now. Things are changing in your favor. Healing is coming. Freedom is coming. Promotion, breakthroughs, all will be well with you in Jesus' name. And if you receive it, can you say amen?
Amen. Y'all are already clapping. Pastor said if Chris were here, he'd say something. Well, I'm looking at a miracle right here, and this is Chris Harvey. He is here. Come on, let's celebrate what God has done in his life. A miracle, a walking miracle. Chris, maybe there's people right now who feel like they're in the middle, you know, like you were. What would you want to encourage them with today?
God is faithful. Stay in peace. It's contagious that people are crying. I'm sorry. Stay in peace. He will help you and bless you as much as you need Him to.
Yes.
If He can do it for me.
Come on.
He can do it for you.
Come on. Amazing.
God bless you.
Amazing. Amazing. Listen, today, if you're in the middle and you need a miracle, can you just lift your hand in the air? I don't know what area, if it's financial, if it's in your body, if it's in your marriage, if you need a miracle. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, you see every hand lifted, and I join my faith with Chris and many others to believe that right now you are setting miracles in motion. God, I thank you that you are supernaturally healing bodies. Father, I thank you that you are supernaturally providing those who need finances right now. You are doing supernatural financial miracles. God, I thank you that you are bringing the lost home. I thank you that you are bringing dead things to life. God, right now, as we've released our faith concerning this area of our lives, you are releasing miracles. In Jesus' name we pray. And if you believe it, can you say amen today?
Amen.
Amen today. Come on, can we celebrate this miracle as a walking miracle? You're in the middle of a miracle, amen? Hey, can we just take this moment as we're all standing? I just want to seize this opportunity of faith. Maybe you've come into church today and you don't know Jesus. You don't have a relationship with Him, or you're watching online or listening by way of radio and you've yet to step into a relationship with Jesus. Surrendering your life to Him, putting all of your trust into His hands. Listen, today is a great opportunity for you to commit your life to Christ or recommit your life to Christ. I'm gonna ask you to do something bold in just a moment. If you wanna give your life to Jesus, receive His grace for all your mistakes, step into purpose. You know, there's a lot of things you can put your trust in. There's a lot of things you can seek after for purpose or for peace. But is there anyone else in here that knows that there's only one that can give us the peace that our soul longs for, and that's Jesus? That's putting our trust in Him. Can anyone testify to that? That Jesus is the only one that can satisfy your soul. Some things can temporarily do it, but He is the only one that can sustain you and satisfy you. So right now, if you want to come into a relationship with Jesus, or you want to recommit your heart to Him, without being ashamed, I want you to just slip your hand up real boldly and say, that's me today. I want to step into a relationship with Jesus. Lift your hands. I see them going up all over the house, online, those listening by way of radio. Come on, church, let's celebrate. All the hands going up. All of those individuals stepping into a relationship. If you lifted your hand, or even if you didn't, repeat this simple prayer of faith after me. Say, Jesus, I come before you today. And I ask you to forgive me of all my sins and all my mistakes. Come into my heart, come into my life, and wash me clean. Today I choose to make you my Lord and my Savior. I want to live my life for you and only you. In Jesus' name, amen. Church, can we celebrate all the new beginnings? Amazing. We're proud of you. Hey, listen, if you pray that prayer, we want to encourage you. We have a team that's up in the lobbies in our New Beginnings area. We would love to encourage you and help you in this new beginning. Any questions you have, if you want information on how to get connected into the church, we have so many areas that we've designed to help you in your journey of faith. Again, our team would be up there in the New Beginnings area to help you get connected in any way possible. You can also take our New Beginnings class online if you'd like to do that also. Listen, Pastor Joel always says, give a year of your life. Commit yourself into the house of the Lord and to following Him. And a year from now, you'll see your life will be forever better because you did so. Can anyone testify to that? Giving a year of your life to Jesus, you'll be forever changed. Come back as often as you can. We want to be a source of hope and encouragement as often as we can. Let me leave you with a blessing. Number six, let me leave you with a blessing. Posture yourselves to receive it. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you. May the Lord show you His favor and have mercy on you. And may the Lord watch over you and give you His peace. We love you. God bless you. Hopefully you leave encouraged today, and we'll see you very, very soon. Have an excellent week.
What a powerful message. What an inspiring message from Pastor Joel today. Joel's message was one that I think I needed for myself as well. You know, middle of the miracle. We're going to go over some notes, but whatever stood out to you, go in the chats now so we can talk about what jumped out at you during Joel's message today. I want to welcome, give a special welcome to our SiriusXM radio listeners. Thank you so much for tuning in today. And those of you that watched us online, God bless you. We're so honored that you joined us today. If you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel where you can receive messages like this each and every week, go ahead and do that now. Thank you all for joining us. What a great message. You know, there's some notes that I took during it. And I love what he said about right now, God is working behind the scenes of your life. You know, sometimes we can define what our circumstances look like based on what we're waiting for and what we're promising for. You know, earlier we talked about being in the middle of the year and, you know, we start off the year one way and we're about to end the year, but where are we in the dreams that God has given us, the promises that God has given us, the goals that we set forth in the beginning of the year? Where are we with that now? And it's a great time to check in and say, you know what? If you find your place right in yourself in a situation right now where it doesn't look like the miracle is taking place or the dream seems so far away, can you see how God is saying to you today that I am working behind the scenes of your life, that I am putting together every detail, the good, the bad, the bitter, and the sweet is all coming together so that I can show myself strong of who I am in your life, how much I love you, and what when I make a promise, I'm faithful to it. You know, I love that quote. We hear it, and it's in songs where it said, if it's not good, it's not done. And I think that gives us hope to keep pressing on and saying, God, I trust you. Our circumstances can look stressful. Our situations can make us panic. But I love how Joel said, don't allow the panic and stress to define where you are. That is the perfect place to step in a place of peace and trust. You know, peace is a very powerful weapon when we are having to stand against the attacks of the enemy or when we look like defeat is coming our way. Stepping into that peace and saying, God, I'm going to trust you no matter what, is where you end up seeing the victory in your life. I hope this message encouraged you just as much as it encouraged me. And, you know, if you made a decision to accept Jesus into your life today, that is a decision that we are so excited to know about. So if you can go in the chats and drop the word new, type out the word new in the chats, we want to celebrate you. We want to get resources to you. You can also text new to 77377 to get more information about that decision. There's so many decisions that you can make in your life, and there's decisions that you do make every day. But I can guarantee that this decision is one of the most life-changing decisions that puts you on a path of discovering who Christ is in your life, the plans that he has for you. Your history does not determine your future. And when you step into a relationship with Jesus, he shows you the life that he has in store for you. So if you made that decision today, we celebrate you. We are so excited. We have so many people here that want to help support you in your journey. And New Beginnings is an online class that we offer to those that have made that decision or those wanting to grow in their faith in God. And if you go to lakewoodchurch.com, you'll find out more information about this New Beginnings course that'll help you take a deeper look into what it means to be a follower of Christ and how to live out your day-to-day life in faith and what God wants for your life. I love this scripture in Jeremiah 29:13. It says, "You will seek me and you will find me when you seek me with all of your heart." And today you made a decision from your heart and you're taking that step. Maybe you've rededicated your life to God. Maybe at one point you were serving God, but right now you made a decision to rededicate your life to God and start over again. You're seeking God, and I promise you, he's there, and he will find you, and he will give you everything that you need to walk out this journey. New Beginnings resources help you take the next step of faith in your life, and I encourage you to sign up for those classes so that you can grow. If you're in the United States, you can text new to 77377. Or if you're not outside of, if you are outside of the United States, just go to our website where you can learn more information about it. And for those of us that are always here, you know that we do declarations in the service. So if you're new to the faith or you are here each and every week and you are making those declarations over your life, we want to let you know that in the chats you can download the declaration so you can carry that with you each and every day. I love it because, you know, the world can tell us who we are. Our own minds can tell us who we are. But when we make these declarations over our life, what we're saying is who God says we are. And we need that reminder each and every single day. So I want to encourage you to go into the chats, click on the link, and you can download those declarations for you so that you can carry that with you. If there is someone in your life that you're believing for their salvation, and you're believing for them to make this decision to walk into a relationship with Jesus, can I encourage you to not give up? Continue to pray for them. continue to encourage them. You can share the resources that you get from YouTube and lakewoodchurch.com. You can share that. But another great way would be to invite them to watch next week with you, or have them come in person here at the church. And that's a great way. You never know when their moment is. And so I want to encourage you, for those of you that are believing for someone to step into that relationship with Jesus, don't give up. Keep praying. Keep believing. We hope that you were blessed and encouraged with today's worship and the message. This will be available later for you to watch again on our online channels. But follow us on social media. Subscribe to the YouTube so that you don't miss anything that's coming up this week. I love that Joel says, when you start off your week in the house of the Lord, the rest of your week goes so much better. You know that God will reward you for the time that you invest and what you prioritize. And I'm a firm believer of that. I see that each and every week in my life. And Sundays are one of our favorite days around here at Lakewood. And we're so honored that you've made a decision to come home to Hope today. So we love you. We pray that you have a wonderful week. Know that God is with you in every area of your life. He's walking with you. He's guiding you. He's ordering your steps. Go in faith and have a wonderful week. God bless you.